Now we will study about additive identity. What is topic? Additive identity. So first of all, additive. Additive means our operation is of addition. Our operation is of addition. Now second topic. Second name is identity. Identity means uniformity. Uniformity, that means remains same. Remains same. It means identity does not affect any number. Identity is a number that does not affect on any number. So we will learn what is additive identity. Additive identity is a number, that when added to any of the rational number, it always gives the same rational number again. Let us understand more clearly. If I have x as a rational number, then I have to find a number. I have to find a number that added to any of the rational number, it always gives the same rational number again. It means x plus, let I am taking y as additive identity. It is equal to x. So solve, y is equal to x. This x will come to that side with minus sign. It is equal to 0. It means 0 is a rational number. When added to any of the rational number, it always gives the same rational number again. It means 0 is our additive identity. Let us understand with following example. X is 1 by 2. If I have rational number 1 by 2, then 1 by 2 plus 0. It is again 1 by 2. 3 by 5 plus 0. It is again 3 by 5. So our additive identity is 0. Final result is additive identity equals to 0. Equals to 0. Now we will learn about additive inverse. Additive inverse. Additive inverse means we have a number. Let us assume we must have a number such that number, when added to any of the rational number, it gives the result as additive identity. Let us understand more clearly. If I have x as rational number, any of the rational number, let I am taking x. I have to find y, which is additive inverse, So additive inverse means a number when added to any of the rational number, it gives the result as additive identity. Or additive identity was 0. Okay, so it means x plus y is 0. It means y is 0. X comes with minus sign. So it is minus x. It means our additive inverse is minus x. Additive inverse is minus x. And it is also called as negative of x. It is also called as negative of x. Let us take example. If I have x is 1 by 2, then our additive inverse was minus x. Minus x means minus 1 by 2. And you can check this result as x plus minus x must be 0 by definition of additive inverse. Here x is 1 by 2 plus minus x is minus 1 by 2. So 1 by 2 plus minus is minus, minus 1 by 2. It is equal to 0. It means our additive inverse of any rational number x is minus x. And this is also known as negative of x. Now we will discuss some more examples. So question is, write the additive inverse of followings. We have to write additive inverse. So our first rational number is 3/4. And you know that additive inverse of x is minus x. Very good. So if x is 3/4, minus x means minus 3/4. Minus 3/4. This is your additive inverse of 3/4. Second example, if I have x is minus 1/2, then additive inverse means minus x means minus minus 1/2. And you know very well that minus minus become plus. So it is 1/2. It is 1/2. So additive inverse of minus 1/2 is 1/2. Now come to third example. If I have x is minus 5 upon minus 6. Now you have to write the additive inverse of this number, this rational number. So you will write minus x. Okay, minus x is minus 5 upon minus 6. Minus minus this cancel. So it will 5 upon 6. Now this minus outside the bracket, and this gives you result as minus 5/6. So the rational number was minus 5 upon minus 6, and its additive inverse is minus 5/6. This was all about additive inverse. Now there is one more type, that is, if the question is you have to verify that minus of x is equal to x, then how will you do? If your x is 1/2, so you have to verify what? Minus of x is equal to x. So you will solve first left hand side part. Left hand side is minus, bracket start, minus, and your x is 1/2. It is equal to minus as it is. Now see, minus minus, it cancels and it gives you plus 1/2. It means only 1/2, and this is same as your x. So you verified that minus of minus x is equal to x. Come to second example. Second example is, if you have x is equal to minus 3/4. So now how will you proceed? Minus minus x means minus as it is, then minus, then x. X is minus 3/4. It is equal to minus as it is, minus minus plus. So it is 3/4 only. And then after simplification, this minus will come with 3/4. So it gives you minus 3/4. Here note that your x was minus 3/4, and minus of minus x gives you again same as x. So verified. Now come to third example. If your x is minus 2/3. Now left hand side. Minus of minus x. Minus as it is. Then again minus, and then you have to write x. This is minus 2 upon minus 3. So minus 2 upon minus 3. Minus as it is, bracket. This minus again as it is, minus minus cancel. So you are left only with 2/3. Now see, minus minus plus. So it is 2/3. And note here that your x was minus 2/-3. And minus minus cancel, and that gives you 2/3. So it means your x was 2/3. And your left hand side also gives you 2/3. It means both numbers are same. So this topic is done.